Ma'am, can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am, I'm seeing, ma'am.
Can we start the class?
Yes, ma'am, start, ma'am. So good morning, students. This is Lakshmi Fani Karunya, JL Max, Lingampally Boys. Today we are going to deal with a new chapter, permutation and combination. Okay, here what is meant by permutation? We'll say, and what is meant by combination? See here, what is meant by permutation? Permutation is the arrangement of items in which order matters. So how you have to arrange a set of items, that is called a permutation. So here permutation will take place two steps, which is nothing but selection and arrangement of the items. Okay, in which how the order comes. So here mainly the order gives a prominent role. Okay, coming to the combination. Combination is the selection of items in which order does not matters, okay? But only selection matters. So here, the number of ways of selection of items is called a combination. So in permutation, we'll have the formula as NPR. NPR is equals to N factorial by N minus R factorial. What is N factorial? So for example, 6 factorial it is there. So how you will write the 6 factorial beta? 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So at last you have to multiply till 1, from 6 to 1. Similarly, n factorial means n, n minus 1, n minus 2, up to so on, 2 and 1. Similarly, n minus r factorial also you have to do. So what is the formula for permutation? NPR is equals to n factorial by n minus r factorial. Similarly, what is ncr? Ncr is equals to n factorial by r factorial into n minus r factorial. Okay, so you have to see the difference between npr and ncr. Okay, next we move on to the next ma. See, we move on to the first problem. What is the first problem? Find the number of all 4 digited numbers that can be formed using the digits 0, 2, 4, 7, 8 without repetition. So here you have a formula for without repetition. See here how many digits he has given. 4 digits, the numbers you have to form by given 5 digits. Okay, so what are the numbers he has given? 0, 2, 4, 7, 8. So if 0 is one among the given digits, then how you will write, ma? The sum of r digit number that can be formed using n digits is n minus 1 into p into r minus 1. It's nothing but n minus 1 p r minus 1. Okay, into sum of the digits into 1, 1, 1. How many times you have to write? R times, which is equals to n minus 2 minus n minus 2 p r minus 2 into sum of the digits into 1, 1, 1 into r minus 1 times. So since here, totally how many numbers are there, ma? 5 numbers are there. But how many digits you have to find? 4 digit numbers. Okay. So therefore, how you have to write the sum of all 4 digit numbers that can be formed using the digits 0, 2, 4, 7, 8 without repetition is, so n here 5. So what is the formula? N minus 1 p r minus 1. So 5 minus 1 p 4 minus 1 into sum of the digits. What is the sum? 0 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 8 into R. How many times it should be repeated, ma? R times. So R is 4, right? Therefore, 1, 1, 1, 1 minus N minus 2 PR minus 2. What is N here? 5 minus 2 P R minus 2. R means 4 minus 2. Okay? So, into sum of the digits 0 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 8 into R minus 1 times 1 should be repeated. 1, 1, 1. So, by simplification, what you'll get? 4P3 into 21 into 4 times 1 minus 3P2 into 21 into 111. So, by simplification, you will get, take the 21 common. So, if you multiply 24 into 111, you'll get 26644 minus 24 into, if you multiply 6 with 111, you'll get 666. So, by taking common 21, you'll have, by simplification, 21 into 25998, which is nothing but 5,45,958. So, how many total number of four digit numbers you can find using 02478 without repetition? 5,45,958 numbers you can find out. So, here what you have to remember, you have to remember the formula that the sum of R digit numbers that can be used any N digit numbers. That formula you have to remember better. Okay. So, next we move on to the next slide. So, here I'm giving a homework for you, assignment. What is that? Find the sum of all four-digited numbers that can be formed using the digits 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 without repetition. I hope you will do this problem. Okay, beta. So, do there. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. So, next, we move on to the next one, ma. So, what is the second problem? Find the number of five-letter words that can be formed using the letter of the words consider. See here, in the consider, total number of words, how many you have, ma? 8. C-O-N-S-I-D-E-R. 8 letters are there. Among 8 letters, you have to find five-letter words. So, what is the question he is asking? How many of them begin with C? How many of them begin with C? How many of them end with R? And how many of them begin with C and with R? So, we have to check it out, Amma. So, here, how many letter word we have to find? 5-letter word. Okay, coming to the solution. The number of 5-letter words that can be formed using the letter consider word. So here, how many total number of letters are there? 8. So how many number of letters we have to find? 5. So how many ways, ma? 8P5. Here N is 8, R is 5. So 8P5 ways. So which is nothing but 8 into 7 into 6 into 5. So how? It is a simple formula, ma. So here NCR means up to R minus 1 you have to write. Similarly here 8 into 7 into 6 into 5, which is nothing but 6720. Okay, coming to the next step, the number of 5-letter word begin with C. So which is nothing but among 8 letters you have to keep one letter constant, right? So that is nothing but C. Then how many remaining places are there? 7 places are there which can be changed. Therefore, you have to write 7P4. So, what is the 7P4 value? 7 into 6 into 5 into 4, which is nothing but 840. Again, the number of 5-letter word end with R. Again, if you consider 5-letter word, if the 5th place is occupied with R, remaining 4 places are there which you can change the words, right? Therefore, how you can write those 4 places among the 7 words you have to pick it out. Therefore, 7p, 4. Again, you will have 840 beta. So now, the number of five-letter word begin with C and end with R. See, begin with C and end with R means among five-letter word, the first place C is fixed and the last place R is fixed. So in between three places are there, which we have to choose. Already two letters are fixed, C and R. So the remaining three letters can be chosen from six letters of the consider. Therefore, how you can write? So one is fixed. Therefore, one into among six letters, you have to choose only three. Therefore, 6P3. So 6P3 means what is the value? 6 into 5 into 4, which is nothing but 120. So this is how you have to find. See, if the letter is beginning with C means the first place C is fixed. Therefore, the remaining four letters must be chosen among the seven letters. Therefore, you are writing 1 into 7P4. Again, if the five-letter word is ending with R means the last place is fixed with R. Therefore, the remaining four letters can be chosen from seven letters. Therefore, 7P4, you are writing beta. Okay? I hope you understood, Nana. Coming to the next one. So, third problem. What is the third problem? If the letters of the word master are permutated in all possible ways, and the words this formed are arranged are the dictionary order, then find the ranks of the words. You have to find the ranks of the words. What are that, ma? Remast and master. So what he is saying? So first of all, he is asking to permutate all the possible ways of the master. But he is asking to form these words arranged in a dictionary order. How you will see in the dictionary, Amma? The dictionary, if you observe, if it is A, then the next letter will be A, B. All the words of A, B meanings will be there. And then A, B, A. Then A, B, B. Like that, if you observe the dictionary order, he is asking to find the rank of the two words. What are those two words? Remast and master. So first one, what is the alphabetical order of the remast? A, E, M, R, S, T. Okay. So the number of words begin with A is how many words you can begin, ma? So there are six letter words. Begin with A means only A is fixed. Remaining five spaces are there. Those five spaces can be written in five factorial ways, ma, which is nothing but 120. Okay. The number of words begin with E. E means, again, E is fixed and the remaining five places can be interchanged. Therefore, how many ways you can write five factorial ways? That is nothing but 120. Again, the number of words begin with M. Similarly, M is fixed. Remaining five places can be interchanged with among the letters. Therefore, five factorial ways, which is nothing but 120. So again, the number of words begin with R, A. See, here he's asking remast. So if the first letter is R, in the dictionary order, we get the second letter immediately, Emma. Understood? Therefore, two letters are fixed among six letters. So remaining four spaces are there, which we have to fill among those letters other than R and A. So how many ways you will have? Four factorial ways, which is nothing but 24. Okay. So again in the dictionary order, if RA is finished, then among the alphabetical order, you will get REA. So again, REA means how many times you can have the words. If three letters are fixed, REA is fixed, then only three spaces are there, which we have to fill other letters. So which is nothing but 3 factorial ways, which is nothing but 6 mark. Okay. And next, what is that? Remast is the next word according to the dictionary. See here, R-E, other than A, you have to fill with M. M means according to the dictionary order, M-A will become. So after M-A, A after letter is S, and then after letter is T. Therefore, remast is the full word you have to came. Therefore, 1 factorial ways you can find a word. So by adding all these terms, how much you will get, ma? You will get the rank of the word remast, which is nothing but 3 times of 120 plus 24 plus 6 plus 1, which is nothing but 391 ways. Okay, beta. So you have to follow this according to the dictionary mode. Coming to the next problem. So master, what is the next word? Master. So first we have to arrange the master in the alphabetical order. So by arranging in the alphabetical order, what you will get? A, E, M, R, S, T. Okay. So the number of words begin with A. So fix the six letter words in which A is fixed. So the remaining 5 spaces will be there. So 5 spaces can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. So you'll get 5 factorial means what, beta? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. By multiplying all those terms, you'll get 120. Again, the number of words begin with E. If you fix E, then the next 5 letters can be arranged among the letters. Therefore, how many ways you can arrange them in 5 factorial ways, which is nothing but 120. So the number of words begin with, see here, next word is nothing but M. M means according to the dictionary, M-A will be game. M-A-E will come. Therefore, the word begins with M-A-E is 3 words, 3 letters are fixed. How many spaces are there? 3 spaces are there. Those 3 spaces can be arranged in 3 factorial ways, beta. So 3 factorial is nothing but 3 into 2 into 1, which is nothing but 6. Again, the number of words begin with M-A-R. So M-A-R is 3 factorial ways, which is nothing but 6 mark. So the number of words begin with M-A. So according to the dictionary, S and E will come. So 4 are fixed mark. How many spaces are there? For 6 letter word, 2 spaces are there. Among those 2 spaces, you can arrange the letters in 2 factorial ways now. So 2 will become. Again, the number of words begin with M, A, S, R is 2 factorial ways. So how many, what is that? 2. So the next word is master. So how many ways you can arrange them? Only in 1 factorial way, which is nothing but 1. So the rank can be find by adding all these values. What is that? 2 times of 120 plus 2 times of 6 plus 2 times of 2 plus 1, which is nothing but 257. Therefore, the rank of the master is 257. Okay. We want to move on to the next one. Next problem, we will move on. Okay. So, do it as homework. If the letters of the word present are permutated in all possible ways, the words thus formed are arranged in dictionary order. Find the rank of the word present. So how you did the previous problem, similarly you have to do. First of all, you have to arrange present in alphabetical order, and then you have to do. Okay. So try it. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Next. See here. Fourth problem. There are 8 objects and 9 boxes. Out of 8 objects, 5 can't fit in 3 small boxes. How many arrangements can be made such that each object can be put out in the box only? So what he is asking, ma? He is asking there are 8 objects, it seems. How many boxes are there? 9 boxes are there. So what he is saying, out of 8 objects, 5 cannot fit in 3 small boxes. Among 8 objects, 5 cannot fit in 3 small boxes. So that means here 9 boxes are not of same shape and size beta. So how many arrangements can be made such that each object can be out in the box only? See here. So how many objects are there? 8 objects are there. How many boxes are there? 9 boxes are there. For the required arrangement, out of 8 objects, 5 cannot be fit in 3 small boxes. That means remaining 5 out of 9, if you remain 3 boxes, how many boxes will remain among 6 boxes? That means 5 objects can be fixed in 6 boxes. So how many ways, ma? 6P, 5 ways. So here, 6 boxes are there, 5 objects you have to fix. So therefore, N is equals to 6 and R is equals to 5. So how many ways you can arrange them? 6P, 5 ways. So the remaining 3 objects can be arranged in 4 boxes. So out of 8 objects, you have removed 5 objects, which we are arranging in 6 boxes. And so out of 8, 5 objects we have removed now. So the remaining 3 objects can be arranged in 4 boxes. So how many ways, ma? 4P, 3 ways. So therefore, total number of arrangements is nothing but 6P, 5 into 4P, 3. So you have to simplify it. If you not simplify also, it is okay. But by using the formula, you just try to simplify it. 6p, 5 means 6 factorial by 6 minus 5 factorial. Again, 4p, 3 means 4 factorial by 4 minus 3 factorial. Okay, beta? Just simplify it. Next, we will move on to the next one, ma. So, next, what is the next one? Find the number of ways of arranging 5 different mathematics books, 4 different physics books and 3 different chemistry books of the same object are together. Okay. So here, what he is saying, Amma? He is saying you have to arrange 5 different mathematics books, 4 different physics books and 3 different chemistry books. Same subjects, such the same subjects should come together. Okay. So first of all, write how many number of mathematics books are there? 5 beta. How many number of physics books are there? 4. How many number of chemistry books are there? 3. So the number of arranging mathematics, physics and chemistry books in 3 factorial ways means first you may put all mathematics books, physics books and chemistry books like that. What is the second method? First physics, next max, next chemistry. Next third method, chemistry, physics, max. So 3 factorial ways you can arrange those 3 subject books. Okay. So 5 mathematics books are arranged themselves. So 5 books are there. So the first book can be kept last. And that means the 5 mathematics books you can arrange, rearrange among themselves. How many ways? 5 factorial ways. Again, 4 physics can be also arranged among themselves. That means 4 factorial ways. Again, 3 chemistry books are also arranged among themselves. That means you can shuffle 3 chemistry books among themselves such that you can place in any order of them. So 3 factorial ways. So totally how many ways, ma? So 3 factorial into 5 factorial into 4 factorial into 3 factorial. Okay. This is how you arrange those books such that all subjects books will come at together. So by simplification, you get a large answer. You may leave it up to here, or else if you have interest, you can simplify it better. Okay, next, we move on to the next mark. So find the number of selecting 3 ovals and 2 consonants from the letters of the word equation. So in the equation, how many ovals are there and how many consonants are there? What are ovals, ma? A, E, I, O, U are ovals. And the remaining are consonants, right? So in the word equation, how many ovals are there? 5 ovals are there. How many consonants are there? 3 consonants are there. So what he is saying, he's asking to select 3 ovals and 2 consonants to form the letters. Okay. So 3 ovals can be selected from 5 ovals. So how many ways you can select, ma? 3 ways. Since here you are selecting, you are choosing combinations. Okay. So 5-3-5 means what is the formula of NCR? N factorial by R factorial into N minus R factorial. That means 5 factorial by 3 factorial into 5 minus 3 factors. 3 factorial. Therefore, by simplification, what you'll got? 10. Okay. Again, you have to choose 2 consonants. That means you have to select 2 consonants from how many consonants, ma? 3 consonants. So how many ways you will write? 3C, 2 ways. So what is the formula? 3 factorial by 2 factorial into 3 minus 2 factorial, which is nothing but 3 answer. So the required number of ways of selecting 3 ovals and 2 consonants is, so you have to multiply 10 into 3, which is nothing but 30. Okay. So next we move on to the next problem. So what it is asking, simplify 34C5 plus summation of R running from 0 to 4, 38 minus R C4. Okay. So we'll see how we will do. So we know that formula NCR plus NCR minus 1 is equals to N minus 1 CR. So according to that formula, here what we have to do, ma, NCR is nothing but 34C5 plus summation R running from 0 to 4. So 38 minus R C4 is equals to, see, simplify here, summation running from where to what, ma? 0 to 4, right? So that means 38C4 plus, in the place of R, first you, if you substitute 0, you will get 38C4. If you substitute 1, then what you'll get? 38 minus 1, 37 C4. Next, if you substitute 2, what you'll get? 36 C4. If you substitute 3, what you'll get? 35 C4. If you get substitute 4, 34 C4. So here, observe, in the first beginning, you have 34 C5 and in the last 34 C4. So you, those two you bring aside. Then what you'll have? 34 C5 plus 34 C4. Plus, again, you bring 35 C4 and 36 C4 aside. Again, 37 C4 and 38 C4 aside. So then what you have, apply the formula, what is the formula? NCR plus NCR minus 1. So according to that formula, what you have to get? N minus 1 CR, right? See here. See here, what you have, ma? So 34C5 plus 34C4. So according to that formula, what I have did? Here. 34, N minus 1, minus 1 side. So 35, C5 plus 35, C4 plus 36, C4 plus 37, C4 plus 38, C4 I have written. So according to that, again, N minus 1 CR. So here, how you get, ma? Again, 36, C5. Here, 36C5 plus 36C4 plus 37C4 plus 38C4.
Again, if you rearrange, what you'll get? 37C5 plus 37C4 plus 38C4. Okay, so again by rearranging them, what you'll get? 38C5 plus 38C4. So what you'll have? 39C5. So what is the formula?
NCR plus NCR minus 1. NCR plus NCR minus 1 is nothing but N plus 1 CR. Here you have a printing mistake mark.
Just check it out. Okay.
We move on to the next problem. So find the number of ways of arranging the letters of the word triangle so that the relative positions of the vowels and consonants are not disturbed. So what he is saying, positions of vowels and consonants should not disturb. Okay. So how many number of vowels are there in the given word triangle? 3 vowels are there. How many consonants are there, Amma? 5 consonants are there. Okay. So according to the triangle, how you have to arrange? See, 2 consonants are there, 2 vowels are there. 3 consonants are there, 1 vowel is there. He's saying that you should not disturb these positions. So first of all, how many vowels are there? 3 vowels are there, no? See here in the middle 2 and the last one. So 3 vowels can be arranged in 3 factorial ways and 5 consonants can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. So therefore the number of arrangements what beta? 3 factorial into 5 factorial. So here should not disturb. That means you should not bring all the vowels at side and all consonants at a side. So according to this position only you have to arrange the letters. Okay. So how many total number of ways are there? 720. Is it clear? Next we move on to the next problem. Next ma. So see, just repeat this problem once again. Here printing mistake is there. Just check it out. NCR plus NCR minus 1 is nothing but N plus 1 CR. So what is the question? 34C5 plus summation R running from 0 to 4. 38 minus RC4 is equals 2. First of all, you split the summation beta from R running to 0 to 4. Okay. How you have to write? 34C5 plus 38C4. If you substitute 0, you'll get 38 minus 0, 38C4. If you substitute 1 beta, what you'll get? 38 minus 1, 37C4. Plus, if you substitute 2 there, 36C4. If you substitute 3, 38 minus 3, 35C4. And if you substitute 4, you'll get 38 minus 4, 34C4. So according to that, you bring all the n terms, equivalent terms aside. What you'll get? 34C5 plus 34C4. So according to the formula NCR plus NCR minus 1, what you'll have? Here n plus 1 CR beta. Just take that. So here 34 plus 1 C5. Okay, 34 plus 1 is nothing but 35. So 35 C5 you'll get. Here 34C4 will be there now. Just both you bring aside. What you'll get? 35C5 plus 35C4. Again, you again apply the same formula. So NCR plus NCR minus 1 is nothing but N plus 1 CR. So 35 plus 1 means 36C5 you'll get. Again, you just bring the 36C4 aside. So what you'll have? 36C5 plus 36C4. Plus 37C4 plus 38C4. Again, it is in the form of NCR plus NCR minus 1. So N plus 1 CR. So 36 plus 1 C5, which is nothing but 37C5. Again, whatever the 37C4 is there, just bring aside. So therefore, 37C5 plus 37C4 plus 38C4. which is nothing but by again applying the formula, you'll have 37 plus 1 C5, which is nothing but 38 C5. And whatever the remaining value is there, 38 C4, just write it down. 38 C4. Again, apply NCR plus NCR minus 1 is nothing but N plus 1 CR. Therefore, 38 plus 1 C5, which is nothing but 39 C5. Therefore, the value of 34 C5 plus summation of R equals to 0 to 4, 38 minus R C4 is nothing but 39 C5. Okay, by this, today we'll end the class, Nana. Okay, thank you.